In this video, I'm going to use digitizing to create an interpolation barrier. The point of an interpolation barrier is when you have samples such as ours that represent physical measurements and you have reason to believe that they are not all spatially equivalent, you want to block an interpolation. And to clarify that, at the bottom of this river, we have samples on the left side and samples on the right side. We know that the original contamination came in from a creek up here, and so it was spread basically upstream or against the current into these areas. I don't want to assume that the samples on the left side are directly related to the samples on the right side to the point where I want to average across those two sets of points. In other words, I want those to be separately treated mathematically. So the way to do that is to create an interpolation barrier, which is basically a line feature class, and the interpolators will not cross that line. In the movie, I've tabbed my table of contents and ArcToolbox, so I'll keep the two of them over here. The first step would be to open a catalog window and to make a new empty feature class inside a geodatabase. In this case, I have a geodatabase I'm using, and I'm making a new feature class. This one is going to be a line feature class, and I'm going to give it the simple name of barrier so I can keep track of it. We don't need to store any values in this. I'm going to use a projected coordinate system on the map that I'm in. It's UTM NAT83 zone 17 because I'm working in Ohio. Tolerance doesn't need to be that accurate. And I don't care what columns are in my feature class. So now I have a feature class called Barrier. Remember, there's nothing in it. And I'll drag it over into my table of contents, and then I will begin to digitize in there. I have set my working environment and my scratch to the geodatabase that we're working inside of. Remember, you click up here on the editor button to open up the editor toolbar. When you do start editing, you select what it is you're editing. I'm editing my barrier. It wants to know what kind of a template you use. I'm double-clicking barrier. I'm getting the choice of line, which is that's correct. So I'm ready now to actually begin sketching the line. I zoomed out a little bit so we can talk about the big picture some more. So the place where I'm trying to block the interpolation is down here. I'm going to put a line across that U-shaped at the down in the south. I want to and probably put a line here to protect the samples that were taken here from being averaged with samples down here, because they're significant processes that are different. One is downstream, one is upstream from the original contamination. Here particularly, I want to have a line along this peninsula, because I really don't want to average these in this bay with the ones in the main river channel. If you digitized the dock as being outside the project, so if you have a peninsula here, you'd want to have a line in that possibly, and maybe right here to stop these two from averaging. So what we're really trying to do is keep the averaging that's going on inside the river where the flow path of the original sediment was. All I need to do is click and create a line. You can see it's snapping over to the edge of the river, which is fine. Double click and I finished that one segment. Now I'll zoom out, put a couple more segments in. Like I said, I think I should have one down at the very southern tip. And I'm zoomed in pretty far because I'm doing this for my for the sake of the movie. You're probably going to want to use more screen real estate. It doesn't matter if it stretches out past the area of concern. If you lose the digitizing cursor, remember that you click up here to bring it back. I think that's all I need to do. I think I have these all covered. If it's a little difficult to see, I could change the line a little so I can tell where I've been working. Well, yellow wasn't a good choice, but I have a line down here, a line there. So I made my barrier purple instead of yellow to close out the shot so that we can see what I've actually done. Pretty simple.